This is some guy named Chris, and in this video, I want to do a test to see if ChatGPT can create a connector for ConnectWise. Just did a video to see if ChatGPT can create a connector, a Power Platform connector to connect to ChatGPT, and it works slightly. So let's see if it can create a connector for ConnectWise. As a hint, I'm gonna say no, but let's try. So, bring up ChatGPT, and we can ask it questions, but we're going to have to probably lead it in the direction. So, let's try. Can you create a custom connector for Power Platform? Let's say Power Automate X ConnectWise. Where it pulls back all companies. We'll make it simple. Please supply the. I don't know why I always ask for please. I always say please. Okay, so it's given us an example. I was worried because there's been another time where it actually, I say, did not want to write the code at all. It was actually telling me, there's another one over here you can see. It was telling me that it did not. I cannot write the code. So let's start here. Let's go from a blank. We'll go. ConnectWise connector demo. I already have a 1 through 8, so in here, and what I'm going to do is take the code, which you saw I copied, paste it into Swagger. Good, again, if you've watched my other videos, this is a good thing that it actually wants to convert it. Looks like it has some success. Let's look here. We got no authentication and the definitions. Now, even to pull back company, I'm pretty sure it has to be company/companies, but it also did miss the operation. So let's just add this. Demo 10. So created a valid connector other than the operation ID. So let's test it. Yep. Handshake failed unexpected packet format. So right away, we didn't set. If this worked, it would have been crazy. But without any username or password or anything. So we need security. We want the API key. And if you do know anything about the ConnectWise connector, you also need a client ID. So let's add in a little couple more things because it also has api.connectwise.com. So let's say are in North America. I have an API key. I'm going to hold off on mentioning client ID as well right now. So let's go back and look at that, because this is a lot more detailed than I've received in the past. Portal custom connectors. So it's actually import the API file. Okay. I've got a developer license. Download the ConnectWise API definition file from here. I'm going to be honest, I don't think I've ever seen the definition file. And if somebody does have something like this, please let me know. But I don't see a definition file. So let's just continue to go with the copy the code as a test. And I'm going to admit, let's just start a new one, because I've run into some issues. So it doesn't like version here, so let's get rid of that. And did it not finish? So it didn't finish. Let's try to do this again. I think what's happening is it's too large here, so we're running into an issue with the return value. So we come up here, edit, and say save and submit. So we're just going to run the same. Hopefully it gives us values. If you have done ChatGPT and you've seen code, it can cut off early and not give you the full due to use. Okay, so it's asking for the API key, so that's a good thing. Still have just companies, but it got the NA here for North America. I'm going to say, isn't the end point companies? And one of the reasons I am looking at that is I know what the API is expecting, and in the documentation, that even this link, the link earlier that we brought up, it can it will show you what the ending endpoints are. Do this. Okay, that's good, that's good. I like that. So right now we're missing client ID header. About client ID. We're going to stop generating on that one because it's not, I'm talking about, let me clarify this. What about the client? We're going to make sure we look at this. So I want the request headers. Actually, let's go with this one. Isn't the client ID a request header. So the thing I've seen in the past, and it, we'll see if it does this, is it puts it with security aspect. So it's trying to get put it into the security. And not the request headers. Okay. Client ID to be added. Okay, if it does that, that might be a good thing. Ooh, I think we might have some success here. Still the API, definition, client ID. We got to get all companies. Let's do a test. So here we're going to do our API key. Good. And then this client, I've got this value. It returned to companies. So as you can see, in the same thing were happened with the ChatGPT side, with building out a custom connector for that, for ConnectWise. As long as you guide it in the right direction, it does return a decent start to a custom connector. I will tell you this, yesterday, at doing a test, they got the version release wrong, and when I asked to update to here, it said it was the newer one that they put was 2019, and this one was built in 2014. So it may just, again, may have to guide it, may have to tell it that it's wrong. But overall, it's building out a decent amount of the code to start to limit having to do the updates. So I would actually say this was a success. But again, if you start doing updates for companies and it's where is it going to fall and short again? So this has been Some Guy Named Chris. Thanks for watching.